Hi guys, let's talk about bonds today. So suppose if there is an institute or there is a company and this company is looking for more capital, so they need more dollars. So there are two options for them. Either they can go to someone and ask for loan, right? And in other case, they can just issue the bond. In this case, the other people, individual or the banks can come and give the loan to the institute. So this can be bank or this could be individual or any kind of other institutes. So they will go and give the loan to the institute, and how that will happen is they will issue a bond. So what they are saying in terms of that is they are saying that we will return you a particular amount of maybe say face value. So this is the face value. So we'll return you this much money after time T, and you have to just give us P today. So if you give us P today, we'll pay you F after time T. So this is kind of a loan, but in this case the loan is not from, they are not going to ask for a loan. They are just issuing the bond and the people are coming and paying the loan or giving the loan to the institute, right? So how will you value the current price? So suppose if the institute is paying you $100 after 1 year, so and the interest rate is 10% and you have 1 year timeline, so in this case the value should be around $91, right? So if you pay $91 right now, you will get $100 after 1 year. So that's a bond which is giving you 10% return. Same way, you can have another bond in which the bond is $100 right now, and instead of paying like different amount, it's paying against $100 at the end. However, in between, it's paying you $10 at each year. So this is first year, and this is second year, and the third year you get $10 again, and then you get the principal. So this is called the coupon option. So the bond with the coupon, and this is no coupon bond. So these are two type of bonds. So how people invest in bonds? So they are, if you think about the investment, so suppose if you have $90 right now, so you want to put that, you want to invest that in the bonds. So if you invest that, you're going to get $90 in the end, $99. Well, let me make it easier. Instead of 90, I'll call it 91, and let's call it 100. So after 1 year, you are going to get $100. So if you're looking for long term, like for 1 year at least investment, then your investment is safe. So it is safe, right? Unless the company goes bankrupt. So you have a safe investment and you have return of 10% for sure, right? However, if you're looking for quick money and you are trying to bet on the change in the interest rate, so right now the interest rate is 10%, right? So you invested your $91. Now there is a change in the interest rate, and the interest rate changes to 2%. So when the interest rate will change to 2%, now the same $100, for same $100, this value should be 98. Now somebody has to pay $98 for them to get $100 in the end. So you don't even have to wait for 1 year. If there is a fluctuation, you can always buy at 91 and sell at 98 without waiting for the full year. So no wait for 1 year, right? So this is how people make money by trading bond, is by just looking at the fluctuation which happens from day to day basis. Same way, bonds have risk, because suppose if you invested at 5%, so you will have 100 and you have approximately 95 here, and you're sure that you're going to get 5%. However, if it changes to 10%, interest rate goes to 10%, now in this case your 100 will become 91. So in the current market, if you need to liquefy your investment, then you are at the loss. However, if you go all the way to 1 year, then you will get your return, so you will have a gain eventually, but this gain will not be same as what the market gains are. So you will be not the gains will not be satisfactory because you invested at the wrong time, maybe considering the interest rate now increased. So I hope this video helped, and I'll see you again in the next video. Thank you.